Okay.
There's a bunch of names here that I didn't see before.
Oh, and that's on one of the following pages.
I see Winnells, Hicksons, McCormicks, Richardsons, Shepherds. Sloan, Rubel,
do you remember anything about, oh, did everyone in the class, well, many times you have students that are, oh, some of them are much better than others, or some of them tend to get in more trouble than others because they're a little more rambunctious, or anything like that?
Well, serious trouble.
Okay. I'm sorry.
It says horrible kind of taught. I can't imagine that.
I'm sorry.
I can't imagine horrible kind of teaching.
You knew Orville?
Yes. He was one of the. He was one of the pupils.
What year was that?
1925.
Well,
I was trying to see when he graduated, if he didn't even.
Let's see if I can find anything.
So many of these names are absolutely not right.
Well, I know that there are some mistakes in that list. That's a very old list that someone made, and we have gotten a cleaner list since then. So I think there must be something wrong there, because in 1925, Orville Cundiff was 15 years old. He didn't go to school in 1926, I know that.
But he did in 24.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, he did go to school in 24. No, that list is basically right, but yes, it is not absolutely accurate. Do you remember the teachers using any sort of punishment? I mean, usually you had to reprimand a student for something. Where they stood in the corner, or...
No.
Nothing like that.
No.
Just had to stay in. Did parents do most of the punishing? So if they knew that their children had acted up at school, they might punish them at home, but the teacher might not do it in the classroom.
I don't don't think. Well, I don't know. I don't know what happened to the other homes. And I never was very naughty, so I never.
Well,
when
that's
I was,
good
I
then.
Took care of it myself. I didn't even get reprimanded when I got home that day.
Oh. You mean when you kicked your sister?
Yeah. I wouldn't have kicked another teacher, but.
No. But your own sisters, that's different. Oh. What's your best memory about one of your teachers?
Good or bad?
Could be either.
The bad memory is the one that sent me on that trip home.
Yes. Now that's definitely a bad memory.
And I remember Bertha as being a good teacher, Bertha Slancy.
Mm-hmm.
My sister didn't teach a whole year, did she?
I don't think so. Let's see if I can find. No, actually she did teach for
did
a whole
she?
Year. Mm-hmm. She made $75 a month. Did she have any training as a teacher, your sister?
I don't think she did.
Okay. But had she gotten a high school diploma, perhaps, or just the eighth grade?
No. She graduated high school.
Here in Lorenz?
Yeah.
And she only taught for 1 year. What did she do after that? Did she get married, or?
Well, she taught at another school I know.
Oh,
and
okay.
That's the one where I think she did teach all year.
Okay. But that was here in the area still?
Yeah.
Was that to get married?
No, she just didn't like it.
Just didn't like it?
She had to stay somewhere else, you know.
Oh, yes. She had to board with somebody else. Didn't like boarding. Huh?
I don't think that was probably part of it.
Do you remember any of the boarding arrangements? Did you ever have any teachers live at your house?
No.
I've lost some questions here.
Oh, I think the drugstore was Carol.
Oh, Carol. Okay.
Carol's drugstore.
Okay.
I think.
C-A-R-O-L?
Two R's and
okay.
two L's.
Okay. Good. You said you would remember it, and you did. Did your teachers ever take you outside for any reason, nature walks or in the spring just to get you outdoors?
Yeah, we used to go.
What kinds of field trips or nature walks?
I can remember going and where we look at flowers and stuff and wildflowers and birds too, I guess. There was one place about, well, not too far from the schoolhouse. I don't know if it had a house on it or not eventually, but it was kind of, or if it had had a house one time, but it was kind of like a place where there should be a home, you know. There's lots of little stuff growing. And I used to go up in there and look around.
What about special activities like at Christmas or the end of school? Did you do something special then?
We used to have Christmas programs. And we'd have a here's a picture of the schoolhouse. We would have it all fixed up here, so it was, I don't know how they did it, but like this would be roped off the backstage here. And
oh, okay.
The program would be here, and there'd be a a curtain.
Okay.
And then draw the curtain, and then have the whatever we had, you know, rest, not plays, but something special.
Okay. Maybe recitations, poetry or songs?
No, it'd be kind of a I don't know. It wouldn't be a play, but it would be kind of a it wasn't just individuals.
Okay.
Do you want to light on?
No, that's fine. I'm fine.
I was gonna ask you. Well, you said you didn't with them.
Yeah, it's better with the camera if there isn't a light. Sometimes that causes a glare. And all the parents would come?
Yeah, if they wanted to.
What about other people in the community? Did they come as well?
Oh, I don't think so.
No, okay. What about at the end of school? Did you have a picnic, some other kind of activity the last day of school?
I can't remember any. We just got our report cards and looked to see if we passed. And I don't know.
Okay.
Eighth graders, when you graduated, you got to, the whole county went to Pocahontas to graduate.
Okay.
So there were quite a few down there.
Now, did other ages of students go as well as those who were getting their eighth grade diploma?
Just go to the...
Yes, just to... Did they have other activities and that going on?
That's the only thing I can remember.
Okay. Okay. Now, but that was a special ceremony.
Yeah.
Sometimes those kinds of events, they would have, activities for all ages of children, races or outdoor activities. And I didn't know if they did that in Pocahontas, but you don't remember.
You mean at graduation?
Yes, at the eighth grade.
I can't remember that.
Okay. All right. Now, was the school used for other purposes? Was it used as kind of a community building?
Well, later on. I don't know if it was even. I don't know how long the school existed, but.
Till 1944.
They used to have voting down there.
Okay. Even when you were in school?
No.
No. Mm-hmm. Okay.
They had voting booths.
Okay. What about clubs? There were, the farm. Well, not Farm Bureau, could have been, but Farm Women's Club. Don't remember. Okay. Was it ever used as a church?
No.
Okay. Sometimes one-room schoolhouses got used as churches occasionally. If a congregation didn't have a building, they would use the school.
No, my folks. Their first home was an old schoolhouse.
Oh.
I can't figure out where they got the old schoolhouse. Because that was long, long, long ago.
Well, I do know around here that, let's say before about 1890, the schoolhouses were built on like sleds. And they would move it wherever the children were. So that if the children grew up, but there were young families a couple miles down the road, they would hook up a team of horses and move it down the road. So, because in fact, there was one case where the county superintendent got mad because someone in this area had moved to school and he hadn't approved it. That's how I know this. So there was a bit of a trial to work this out.
Well, what puzzled me was why anyone would be up to wanting to get rid of a schoolhouse.
Yeah, I don't know. Unless it was too small, but if it was that small, it wouldn't have been enough room for them.
Well, it was a couple.
Yeah. Huh. But that wasn't the house that you lived in.
When I went to school?
Yeah.
No.
That was a different.
Schoolhouse.
Yeah.
It's still on the farm, though.
Oh, is it? Okay. Huh. I'll have to go take a look at that.
Oh, it's not much to look at now.
Let's see. Did you ever give your teachers any presents? Or did she ever give you presents?
You ask such hard things.
Well, I don't expect you to remember everything, but sometimes it, you know, clicks a memory. So.
Well, I don't remember either one.
Okay. When you had recess, how long was recess?
I don't know. 15?
Maybe 15 minutes?
Yeah, I imagine.
Okay. And what kinds of things did you do at recess?
Well, the games we played were, I wrote some of them down. This would be at noon, too, you know. Well, we played basketball.
Oh, basketball. Yeah, that's interesting. Not baseball, basketball.
Oh, I meant baseball.
Oh, okay.
And we played in the snow, of course. And we played Andy Over.
Okay.
pump, pump, pull away. Then there was some, I can't even remember how pump, pump, pull away might have went. Do you know?
No, I don't. I played Auntie Over. But what building did you play Auntie Over over?
The schoolhouse.
The schoolhouse itself. That would be a tall building
yeah.
to throw over. Huh. Did you ever bring toys from home or anything like that?
Bring what?
Toys?
No.
No. Okay. And did the boys and girls play together?
Yeah.
Okay.
We choose up sides usually. And
yeah.
There was some other game too.
Fox and geese?
No.
No. Someone just recently told me this. I'm in Timmy something's territory. I'm in Tommy's. No, I'd never heard of it. And it was drawing a circle. And you tried to put your foot in the circle, somebody was inside. And if they caught you, they would try and touch you. So.
I can't even remember what the. This Andy over.
Mm-hmm.
You throw it over and then you're supposed to catch the ball. But then what were you supposed to do? Run around and catch the kids?
Yes. If you caught the ball, you were supposed to run around the side real quick, but they didn't know which way. And the idea was to get around fast enough so that you could hit somebody with a ball. But if you didn't catch it, you couldn't do that. You had to try and toss it back
yeah.
over the building. Yeah.
So they didn't know if you were coming or if the ball was coming.
No. No. Was there a hitching post in front of the building for the horses?
Not when I went there.
Okay. A pump? A well?
No.
No well.
We always had to go after water.
Okay.
So kids would take turns, the bigger kids. And they would go to the nearest neighbor's house and get a pail of water and bring it back. Our water supply.
Huh. Did they do that just once a day?
Oh yeah.
Okay. So you had to be pretty frugal with your water. Because a pail of water for that many children doesn't seem like very much. Hmm.
Of course we had that jug, I don't know. Maybe they went after the second bill. I don't remember, but I know they took turns. It was a treat to go get the water.
Mm. Could you move, or did you ever move the desks in the schoolroom? Did you ever slide them to one side or another? Okay.
I think they were fastened down.
Okay. Did you have chores at home that you did?
No.
Okay.
I had three brothers.
They did all the work.
Three sisters. Why should I have two?
Well, you were a lot younger than them, but at that age, no, probably they were doing all the work, and, well, that was good. Now, you have some other memories. There are things you've written down. What are those?
Well, we used to have box socials.
Oh, okay. What were the box socials?
Well, the girls would fix up this box. Enough for two people, you know, and decorate it real nice, fancy, bows and all kinds of stuff. And then the boys would bid on it. And you're always hoping, you know, that the right person would get the right box. And, but I can't, I don't know how they did. If they had an auctioneer that, I was trying to think of that the other day, and I don't remember.
Hmm.
And I, surely the parents are there.
Now, what, was this for the very young children, or was it for maybe like teenagers or older children,
well,
or?
I just remember.
You remember doing it yourself?
So, yeah, that's all I remember.
Okay.
And I told you about the programs.
Mm-hmm. All about the Christmas program, yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Were there programs any other time of the year?
There may have been, I don't remember that.
Okay.
Well, we used to have a health nurse.
Health nurse?
Who would stop once a year.
Oh.
And she'd check your teeth and your throat and stuff. I remember she was always sending a note home with me, enlarged tonsils. I hated to take that home because I thought for sure I was going to have my tonsils out. But they disappeared completely.
Oh, well, that was good.
Yeah.
Did she come in the spring then, or the
fall?
We
never knew when she was coming.
Oh.
I don't know when she came, but.
So she'd spend the whole day just looking at children, huh?
Well, she'd look at them all. And
yeah.
Go.
Huh.
And sometimes I remember the county superintendent would call.
What did he or she do when they came?
I don't know what they did. I just thought it was kind of, we thought we were being really tested, you know.
Had to behave really well.
Well, yeah, I know what we're talking about.
Yeah. Hmm.
What kind of lamps do you have in this picture?
They are, well, obviously they're electric now, but they're like
kerosene
yeah. lamps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they look like electric on here, but.
Kerosene.
Then they had little kids' games up in front sometimes, just as part of the.
Hmm.
I remember one was clap, clap, bow.
Clap, clap, bow?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Clap, clap, bow, clap, clap, bow. Stamp, stamp, turn yourself around.
This was a game that you played?
No, it was an exercise.
Exercise?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Okay.
Could have been like at recess when it's winter or something. I don't
know.
Oh,
okay.
I don't know, but I remember doing it.
Hmm. Clap, clap, bow. Well, now, were there?
You stand in a circle.
Okay.
And it was clap, clap, bow. Stamp, stamp, Turn yourself around. Subjects I wrote down.
Mm-hmm.
Reading. And arithmetic, history, geography, grammar, spelling. And probably writing, I just don't. That usually goes with reading, writing, and arithmetic.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, the teacher always had a bell.
A hand bell?
She'd ring it at 9 and at 1 and then at the beginning of each recess. I can't remember if she rang it a little bit when it was time for school to be out. End of recess or not.
And you would end the day at about 4?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think it was from 9 to 12 and 1 to 4.
And did everyone then scurry home or? At 4 o'clock, or did you stay in the schoolyard and play?
Oh, no. I think everybody went home. Of course, the teachers almost had to get there early, you know, to get the fire going. And
mm-hmm.
That was a job, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. That had to be a very hard job.
Oh.
Just teaching all of those different children who were at so many different levels, and it was tough. Yeah. It's not a job I would want.
Do you know? Well, we got to have, there's quite a few from my grade out in country school that went to high school.
Mm-hmm.
And I was surprised at some of the stuff we knew that they didn't know up there.
Oh. So you must have felt as though you got a very good education.
Well, yeah. Felt we did all right.
There was a question I thought of, and I cannot remember it, of course. Well,
this this picture of Marshall Center.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this is of our other museum.
Oh, it's here. I didn't see this before.
Uh-huh. What was interesting was we had the building repainted about 2 years ago. And, well, that's not true. It would have been 1998 when I came out here the first time to go through some records. And we had thought the school was built in 1898. So we thought it was our 100th anniversary. And after I got out here, Annie Olson found some old school records, and it was built in 1893. So at some point, someone couldn't read those numbers, and they made the 3 into an 8, as we think what happened. But it now says 1893 on the front.
Mm. Well, it doesn't say Marshall number 5.
It says Marshall. It doesn't have a number 5 on it. It says Marshall Center.
I can't remember us having shutters, or whatever these are.
Yeah, those are shutters.
But they might have been.
Well, do you have any other memories you wanted to share?
How did my Martha father remember a lot of stuff that?
Oh, I haven't talked to her yet.
Who did she?
I talked to Marguerite Farlow.
Oh.
And she remembered some things, but of course she'd only gone to school 1 year. So she tried very hard to make the distinction between the Marshall Center School and number 8. Which she went to then later. And so she remembered some things and remembered about her father being a teacher.
Yeah, I know he was. Well,
you may remember other things and
I don't
later.
Know.
And
I don't know how important this is, but I could probably be. Do a better job than I did.
Well, that's, yes, if you can, you know, think about it, and you can always send it to me.
Because I know. Since I see these names on here,
mm-hmm.
Like McCormick, you know, I said something about that.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Well, if you want to take more time and study that, and you could always send me a copy of it or ask someone to copy it off for you, because that would be fine.
Oh yeah, here it says logistic number 5.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it said that on the schoolhouse.
Mm-hmm.
Marshall Center number 5.
All the other schools, they seem to have referred to them by their numbers. And very early in the school's history, they used number 5. And then at some point, people started calling it Marshall Center. But the number 5 school was always the center school, so.
Oh.
Yeah. That's why. Well, I appreciate your help with this. I have one more thing I'd like to ask you to do. In your packet, here, I'll pull this out. This is an interview agreement, and I wanted you to read that. There's a front and a back to it. So you take a look at that for me. You want me to turn the light on so you can
no,
see it
that's
better?
Right.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. you're comfortable with all of that, I would then ask you to sign that. All that is just to allow me to use that in our histories that we write of the school.
What's going to happen to this?
This will be kept in the museum's archive, and it will just, it won't be shown publicly. It will be just shown, just to make a transcription off of it, so that we're sure that we've got the information that you've given us absolutely accurate. Now, if you feel as though it's the sort of thing where, you know, as long as you're living, you wouldn't want anyone to see it, but perhaps later we could show it, that's up to you as well.
Is it on now?
Yes, it is. You can make stipulations if you'd like.
Well, I don't care about that kidnapping incident.
Oh, no.
To be.
Yes, we will not repeat that one. No.
But it will be on there.
Well, it will be on there. But these will not be shown publicly. We'll make sure that part is not shown. Okay? If you're more comfortable with that. Yes, please. The 14th. Okay. And what I will do is I will make a copy of this and then I will send it back to you. Okay?
All right.
And I really do appreciate this. This is a wonderful gift you have given. Oh, seriously, because so many younger visitors to the museum, to the school, don't understand what it was like to go to school then. And so you've given us a piece of history. These are the kinds of things that aren't written down in books. These are the kinds of things that official bureaucratic school records don't keep. And so by you talking with me, you're going to save a piece of that history.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll be there for posterity. So.
My teacher, Bertha Snesey,
mm-hmm.
went to Cedar Falls.
Oh, did she?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now that's an important piece of information to know. Now, did she get a 2-year degree from there, or
well, sure
summer institute, or?
I don't know, but I'm sure she got, she graduated.
Okay. I will look on our records and I may be able to find that then. That's great to know.
I think there are so many mistakes on here.
Well, one of the problems, one of the things that they should not have done is they shouldn't have put it like this, because there were 3 different terms within a school year and it was a different set of students in each term. And so when this was written, this was done, well, in 1989 they wrote this. So this is old. And they didn't have the most accurate information. So that's something we will update and we'll make sure it's more accurate.
And all of these, I could probably tell you where everyone lived now since I got this list.
Oh, okay.
But you probably don't.
Oh, it is interesting for us. We'd like to know where everyone did live. Yes.
Here's Albert Brush. It's Albert Bunch.
Yes. See, someone did not do a good job typing.
No.
No. So. that's why we're doing a new list. I just grabbed that one because I don't have our new one done yet. So. Well, now, after you finished your eighth grade, then you came into Lorenz here to high school. Okay. And then what did you do after that?
2 weeks after I graduated,
mm-hmm.
I got a job, and I worked there for 48 years.
Oh, my heavens. 48 years. What did you do?
It's about a block north of here. It was a wholesale grocery house.
Oh.
Cakes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I didn't even go to school.
Huh.
I thought I wanted to be a nurse, but I got this job, and I had no money.
Well, that's...
And I didn't get laid off or anything, so I just kept on working.
Uh-huh.
It was in the Depression, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
So...
You were lucky to have a job.
Yeah.
What? Oh, I should probably take that back. Send you up.
The first paycheck I got was $8 for Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And it wasn't a wholesale grocery then. It was a produce house. They bought eggs and shipped eggs.
Oh.
And bought chickens and dressed them and sent them by the carloads out of Lorenz.
Huh. To like to Des Moines and?
New York.
Oh, really?
Oh, sure.
Oh.
Chicago and big New York.
Huh.
Boston.
Well, that had to be interesting.
But my sister had worked there about 9 months when Lowell Bake said to her one day that we ought to have some more work help in the office. He said, and Esther said, well, would you consider Helen? And he said, sure, tell her to come in the morning. So, so that's how I started. And I used to pay the farmers and stuff for eggs.
Oh, okay.
And poultry. That was probably my very first job.
So you were a cashier?
Well, not really. We didn't have money. We just sent them down to the store to collect. We just figured it out.
Oh, okay. Okay. So more like an accountant, maybe? Or?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Is that what you did? Your job probably changed over 48 years.
I was office manager when I left. And we were a great big wholesale grocery place, biggest in Northwest Iowa. Sold groceries to all over Iowa and different states around.
Huh. Well, that's interesting. Well, it's nice to know what each of the Marshall Center School graduates did.
My sister was also worked there.
Yeah.
And,
that was Esther.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she worked there. She was older than me. Well, she, like I said, 9 months. So, but I worked longer than she did.
Mm-hmm.
She quit. She had she had an accident.
Oh.
She broke her hip. Didn't get to go back.
Oh. That's breaking a hip is a tough thing to do.
And I had another sister that worked in the office too for a while.
Oh.